Hey everybody, Justin with the Pit Lane again. This is part 3 in my Team Losi TLR 22 2.0 technical how-to videos. In this video, I'm going to go over how to assemble the differential on the car, as well as the transmission and the transmission housing, and how that bolts up to the chassis itself. Step C1M, the first step in assembling the differential on the car. Pretty straightforward with this. You've got the outdrive here. You want to be using the one that doesn't have the part sticking up on it, right? Stick a little bearing in the front of it. This large washer is going to go on there with some of the white or clear silicone grease. And then the differential pieces, or I guess the differential bolt, you got the little straight bolt, you basically throw down a washer on it, and I'll take some of the black grease and dab that around that little guy, and then take the diff balls, little tiny diff balls, you can see them down here, and we'll stick those on to the washer one by one and then put it through the outdrive. So the outdrive has been greased up with the clear silicone grease. We put the washer disc on the end, whatever you want to call that guy, and as you can see on this little nut, or bolt rather, you can see I put the grease on it, on the bottom of the washer. There we go. And what I'll do is I put a little bit of grease on the end of this Allen wrench so I can pick up the tiny diff balls, and then we can just stick them on there one at a time. So now you can see we've got all the little bitty diff balls in there. We'll take the the other little tiny washer very carefully and set it down on the top. And pack it in and then kind of just squish everything together. And that puts that together. Then we can drop that into the outdrive itself. And then what I'll do is I'll take the wrench, put this piece on the bottom of the wrench, like that, and then we can take the outdrive and drop it on in there. And then put the little plastic cap part on afterwards. Kind of push that guy into place. There we go. And now we're ready to move on to step C2. Step C2M, again, pretty straightforward. The outdrive with the bearing. This time goes over the part that sticks out, the big diff washer. The spring that you have that comes in it, we're just going to drop that into the outdrive. And then the cap, this is the threaded side of the cap, the larger one, that goes down into the outdrive as well. And we'll get pushed down in there. Continuing on to step C3M, it's basically our main gear, our main diff gear with all the holes in it. I'm going to take some clear grease, kind of fill in all the holes, and then drop all of the little ball bearings the same way I put them on the other part. Basically dip them, or dip the tool in a little bit of the clear grease, pick them up and drop them in there and get those all seated. Now we have all the differential balls inserted into the gear properly and lubed up with the clear silicone grease. Now we're going to put the outdrives around the gear. I like to start with the one with the bearing on that side so it goes into the seat. Bearing seat in the gear itself. Make sure that's in there nice and snug. and then we can go ahead and drop it on top of the other parts. And once that's together, we can go ahead and start screwing the diff together as well. As you can maybe see that, you can see the part slowly sinking in as the diff tightens. Now the manual says to tighten the diff until a resistance is felt while working the diff by hand. Tighten screw down and back off 1/8 of a turn. So I'll go ahead and do that, and then the differential will be assembled. The differential is all tightened up. You'll notice when it's fully tightened and then backed off the 1/8 of a turn, the little notch in the outdrive, the nut that you tighten, or the bolt, I guess that would be the nut that you tighten down onto the diff bolt, is almost all the way down in the bottom of the outdrive there. So basically get this thing tight until it won't turn anymore. You'll probably want to put something in the outdrive, like another Allen key or something like that, so you can tighten it down. And you'll know when you get it all the way tightened, it feels kind of tight at sometimes, but you'll know, you'll hit a hard stop when the diff is fully compressed, and that's when you want to back it out the 1/8 of a turn. When you back it out the 1/8 of the turn, if you hold the diff gear, it should turn like so. If you've got it too tight, you're not going to be able to turn the other outdrive like that with the differential, so keep that in mind. Steps C4M through C6M are all pretty straightforward. I've got all the parts laid out right here. I already pre-seated all the bearings and the pins, the gear guides into the transmission case, and I already attached the motor mount. Nothing too difficult about that. You want to make sure you use thread locker, on the bolt that goes into the mounts, and got the bearings pre-seated inside this guy as well. Basically, all you do is drop the little gears onto the pins. We're going to drop our differential inside the transmission housing. We want to make sure the screw for the diff, where we can tighten it and loosen it, is on the right side of the transmission case. So since we're running mid-motor, our motor is going to be up here, car's facing that way. We're putting the nut or the bolts where we tighten the diff out on this side right here. Attach the case, and then it's just a matter of screwing it down with the correct button head screws that you're given in the kit, and just make sure they go in the right spot. And I think one or two of them do get some thread locker in the end, the ones that thread into the back of the motor mount plate. Next step, C7M, going to put the slipper clutch together. Since I'm going to be running this thing in a 17.5 stock class, racing at first, you put in the 70 tooth spur gear, which is this guy, and it comes in its own separate little bag, labeled stock spec racing, so I'm going to use that. I already dropped on there's a little red sleeve that goes in the middle there, down on the idler gear shaft. You can kind of see it there. So I already dropped that on there. You drop on one of the slipper clutch sides, and then what we're going to do to try to get this gear, you have to orient it a certain way, or the clutch, or whatever you want to call it, the little slipper pad, the little yellow pad. You got to get it orientated into the notches in the gear, so keeping that thing positioned right will be a bit of a trick, but we'll see how it goes here. So I finally got the gear with the slipper pad down on the backside there. It is a bit of a pain to get it right and make sure it stays oriented properly on the gear. So I've got the other side now on. I'm going to drop on the other side of the clutch, drop that down on the gear, squeeze it up nice and tight, follow that up with the black spring, a little red cap, and this is got a hat on it. I want to make sure that hat faces downward, right? And then follow that up with the nut. Step C9M, we're getting ready to throw the completed transmission onto the car itself. As you can see, I've got everything put together. Got the slipper clutch on. That's all good to go. This basically just drops into the back of the car. Let's see if I can get you a better angle here. You got to make sure your dog bones get put into the inner out drives. It's easy just to throw on one side and then get the other side put in after the fact. Okay, that's in. Now we can kind of guide the transmission into place and then just kind of give it a little bit of jiggle and it'll seat itself into the slot on the bottom of the chassis right there. So everything seats in nice and snug, and then we've basically got the four screws on the bottom there to tie the transmission case into the chassis. So I'll pop those guys on along with two screws in the back here, and we've also got the rear chassis brace that bolts up similarly on the motor mounts and the transmission, somewhat like that. So we get that thrown together, nothing too tricky, just follow the manual, screw the right screws in where they belong, and it should be pretty simple. That does it for the transmission assembly. It is now installed onto the rear of the buggy with the chassis brace as well. Got all the screws tightened up and put in place, including the ones on the bottom of the chassis. So it's all good to go. I can start working on the shocks and get those built, and then move into electronics and getting the rest of it put together. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video and hope they helped out.